We now start the rite of the ordination of the new priest. I just go through very quickly so you can follow. We'll start by taking your final affirmation for reverence in Axios, followed by that you will recite the vow of commitment of the new priest, followed by the liturgical prayer, started by thanksgiving prayer. Investment for the service, and this and the follow him to enter to the altar, and this concludes the first part. Then we will continue with the divine liturgy, and in the end, you will come. Of course, you will participate in prayer. Usually, you will prepare the communion of the saints as a tradition of the diocese of the new priest. But of course, it's not necessary for the new priest. And then, what is necessary is before the end, he would recite after me the last confession. I mean, I believe, I believe. While I'm holding the holy body, he will put his hands on my hands up and down. So we give him the faith or faith by following the reciting of the last confession, which summarizes our faith. And then before he takes communion, he will receive the Holy Spirit of the priesthood by opening his mouth, saying, I open my hands and receive the Spirit, the Lord breathing his faith, and say, accept the Holy Spirit, and the Lord did for his disciples after the resurrection, when he said to them, in their face and said, receive the Holy Spirit and give them the authority to forgive and to buy the sin. And after we finish the Holy Communion, it will be the procession of the new priest. At the end of it, he will come and hear the command of the new priest. This concludes the first part of the celebrating part, which we will have together in the hall downstairs. And then tomorrow you will participate in the liturgy. You cannot pray the liturgy in this hall until you go to the monastery and receive the light of the divine liturgy from a monk in the monastery, go to the Abishon monastery and spend 40 days. Then after the end of the 40 days, you will come back and in the vesper. First vesper after visiting there, there will be special hour for receiving the new priest in the church. He's going to serve. So I wish him a successful and fruitful service. And we thank again in the same minutes with Paul and the other people spreading this blessed information. So the first part is we need your final acclamation from him and to be obtained as the priest. Thank you.
before his angels and saints, before my father, his holiness, the commission of the third room, my father, the bishop, the metropolitan of the head, and before my father, the bishop, the son, and all the clergy, to be steadfast in the holy Orthodox faith until the last breath, to respect the canons of the Holy Church, to keep all traditions, rites, religious customs, and teachings. I will make every effort to teach the people the true faith and lead them in a holy and righteous life, and to be an example for them in every good deed. I vow to love the flock and deal with the people with compassion and wisdom. In pastoral care, in concern for them in every respect and their last of my abilities, I will search for the problem and try to return home. I will gather the scattered flock of God. I will not ignore the incapacitated, the rejected, of those who have no one to bear with me. I will be patient and long-suffering in dealing with all people, and will show and will not show partiality to a chosen group, but be equally concerned for all. I vow to put Christ and His Church before everything else. I will stay away from the love of money and the loving of the bigger portion. I will not boast over the people, nor will ever neglect them or overburden them. I will not order them against the commandment of the Lord, and will never reject the repentant when he returns to the church, but will serve him. I vow to submit to the hierarchy of the priesthood representing the person of His Holiness, the Pope of Alexandria, and the Patriarch of the See of St. Mark, and His Grace the Bishop of the Diocese of Los Angeles, along with their eminences and graces, the metropolitans and bishops of the Church. To them, I will give my respect and honor to their dignity. I ask the Lord to grant me strength through your prayers, so that I may fulfill the duties of this great office of honorable priesthood with honesty and integrity. Pray for me, my fathers and brothers and sisters.
Oh. All glory to the only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
and to the ages of ages.
Oh. ربنا صلاتك وأجلنا معك وأجدرنا معه لصلاحك إن عمل ونربع في الوزن ونلال معه للذين عمروا مشيئتك كنت ألبد أبرة الوكيل الأمين الحكيم في ظهور ربنا وإلهنا مخلصنا يسوع المسيح هذا الذي بحريه منك